Blurring an image is a popular image manipulation, but have you ever wondered what really happens behind the scenes? This is what we'll see today. In image processing, a kernel, also known as convolution matrix, is a small matrix that gives us the ability to apply effects on an image, like sharpening, blurring, and edge detection. The idea is that, in a copy of the image that we want to transform, for each pixel, we put our kernel on it, and we multiply the value of each pixel by the constant on the kernel and we do the sum. We get a new pixel that replaces the old one. Basically, we calculate the weighted average of neighbors of the actual pixel. For example, for edge detection, a possible kernel is 010, 1-41, 010. So for each non-edge pixel, we multiply the top left pixel by 0, the top pixel by 1, the top right pixel by 0, the left pixel by 1, the actual pixel by -4, the right pixel by 1, the bottom left pixel by 0, the bottom pixel by 1, the bottom right pixel by 0, we do the sum, and we get the value of the actual pixel on the new image. Here is an example, the new value of the pixel 11 is 11. After doing so for each non-edge pixel, we get the result after applying edge detection. And for blurring, same logic, it just uses a different kernel. For box blur, for example, the one we'll learn about today, it has a kernel of 111, 111, 111, and the result has to be multiplied by 1 divided by 9. And because multiplying by 1 gives the same number, for each non-edge pixel, we just do the sum of itself and pixels around it, and we divide by 9. Here is an example. After performing this operation on each non-edge pixel, we get the image blurred by using box blur. In code, we will use the PIL Python module to manipulate images, and we will work with RGB, so each pixel will have a tuple of 3 values, one for red, one for green, and one for blue. We make a function that takes as parameter the path of the image, opens it, creates a copy of it that will be our result image, and we can start working. We create a copy because if we do everything in place, we will lose old values of pixels, which will change the result when calculating next ones. We store the dimensions of the image in two variables, width and height, and we can start. We want to avoid edge pixels because they don't have enough neighbors, so we avoid the first and last row, and the first and last column. This is why in our loops, x and y, the position of the actual pixel, go from 1 to width -1 and 1 to height -1 respectively. Now for each pixel, we create a variable sum, which is a tuple of 3 zeros because we're working with RGB, then for each neighbor including the actual pixel, we get its RGB value and we add it to our sum. After doing so, we divide the result by 9 as said earlier and we assign it to the actual pixel but in the new image. After the loops, we return our new image, which is the input image but blurred by using box blur. In reality, what we did here is a box blur of radius 1, but we can create a more powerful blur by increasing the radius. For example, here is our original image, after blurring it with a radius of 1, after blurring it with a radius of 5, and after blurring it with a radius of 20. To increase the blur, we just increase the kernel size. With radius 1, we had a kernel of size 3 because we were working with neighbors that are up to 1 level around the actual pixel, and we divided by 9, the area of the kernel. With a radius of 2, we get a kernel of size 5 because we work with neighbors that are up to 2 levels around the actual pixel, and we divide by 25, the area of the kernel. In a general way, with a radius of r, we get a kernel of size 2r plus 1, and after getting the result, we divide it by 2r plus 1 squared, the area of the kernel. Values inside the kernel remain 1. In code, let's modify the function we made now. First of all, we add a parameter r, we can set a default value of 1 to it. Then we add a line to calculate the area of the kernel because we will need it later, it's 2r plus 1 squared. Now in loops, we don't skip just the first and last row and column, we skip the first and last r ones. In the previous function, we skipped just 1 because the radius was 1. So now x and y go from r to width minus r and r to height minus r respectively. We skip them because pixels there don't have enough neighbors. And inside the loop, we need to do the sum of pixels of all levels around the actual pixel. So we need to calculate the sum of pixels of the square subimage that goes from x minus r y minus r to x plus r y plus r. This is why we traverse pixels ij, where j goes from y minus r to y plus r, and I goes from x minus r to x plus r. We added plus 1 because the second parameter is exclusive. After getting the sum, we divide it by the area and we assign it to the actual pixel but on the new image. And after the loop, we return the image. By using the function, here is what we get with r equal to 20 for example. But you can see that edge pixels have not been blurred. Remember that we didn't traverse them because they don't have enough neighbors. We need something to fix it. We can, for example, just remove the edges after blurring or extending the boundaries before blurring. For the time complexity, the outer loop does weight minus 2 r iterations, the inner loop does height minus 2 r iterations, and inside it, the cost is 2 r plus 1 squared, the area of the kernel we're using. After simplifying, we get a time complexity of O of h times w times r squared. Now the question is, can we optimize this function? The hw is inevitable because we need to traverse almost all the pixels, but we can optimize the cost of calculating the weighted average of a pixel, which actually costs 2 r plus 1 squared. The advantage with BoxBlur is that all the values in the kernel are the same, which means that we can reuse the actual sum in the next iteration. The reason behind it is that two adjacent pixels have only 2 r plus 1 different pixels, so if we have the sum of neighbors of the actual pixel and we want to calculate the next one, we subtract the 2r plus 1 pixels that went out of the kernel and add the 2r plus 1 pixels that entered the kernel. The cost of doing so is 2 times 2r plus 1, which is 4r plus 2, which is an O of r. Multiplied by the number of iterations, we get an O of h times w times r time complexity, better than O of h times w times r squared. What if I tell you that we can optimize it more? We can actually calculate the weighted average in O of 1 time. We can do so by using what we call a summed area table. The summed area table is a table where table of ij represents the sum of elements of the submatrix from 0,0 to ij. For example, here table of 1, 2 is 24 because 5 plus 1 plus 2 plus 6 plus 2 plus 8 is 24. Know that here it's a 2D table, but it can be of any dimension. We will use a 2D one because images are 2D tables of pixels. And after building it, we can get the sum of elements of any submatrix in O of 1 time. Let me show you how. First of all, we need to build the table, and obviously, we won't recalculate everything at each cell, it would be so time consuming. The trick is that we use values that we calculated before. To calculate the sum of elements of the submatrix from 0,0 to ij, we take the value of matrix of ij, we add to it the sum of elements of the submatrix from 0,0 to i-1j, we add the submatrix from 0,0 to ij minus 1, and you can see that we counted some elements twice. So we subtract their sum, which is in reality the sum of the submatrix from 0,0 to i minus 1 j minus 1. And we get the value of table of ij. So table of ij is matrix of ij plus table of i minus 1 j plus table of ij minus 1 minus table of i minus 1 j minus 1. For example, table of 4,3 is matrix of 4,3, 9, plus table of 3,3, 53, plus table of 4,2, 56, minus table of 3,2, 37, we get 81. But we have some edge cases, in the first row because table of i-1j is out of the grid, and in the first column because table of ij-1 is out of the grid. To handle them, in the top left cell we just put matrix of 0,0, in remaining cells of the first row we put matrix of 0j plus the previous cell of the table, table of ij minus 1, and in remaining cells of the first column we put matrix of i0 plus the previous cell of the table, table of i minus 1j. Now that we fill the table, we can get the sum of elements of any submatrix in O of 1. To do so, if we want the sum of elements of the submatrix from I star j star to I n j end, we start by taking the sum of elements from 0,0 to INJ end, but we have to subtract unwanted cells. So we subtract table of INJ start minus 1, we subtract table of I start minus 1 J end, but we subtracted some cells twice. So we add table of I start minus 1 J start minus 1. For example, here if we want to get the sum of the subrectangle from 3,2 to 5,3, we take table of 5,3, we subtract table of 5,1, we subtract table of 2,3, and we add table of 2,1. We get 93 minus 39 minus 45 plus 17, which is 26. And you can verify that is the sum of the subrectangle. 5 plus 2 plus 7 plus 9 plus 2 plus 1 gives 26. Now let's apply this to our problem. We have an image made of pixels and we want to build the summed area table. Here we are working with tuples, and in Python, directly using arithmetic operators with tuples doesn't give us the result that we want. For example, with addition, we want to add each pair together, while adding two tuples in Python just concatenates them. This is why we will use map and operator module. First of all, we start by creating a table that has the same dimensions as our image, where elements are initially tuples of 3 zeros. Now in table of 00, we just put the RGB value of the pixel 00. Then in remaining cells of the first row, we put the RGB value of the pixel x0 plus the value of the previous cell, table of 0x-1. Then in remaining cells of the first column, we put the RGB value of the pixel 0y plus the value of the previous cell, table of y-1, 0. Then in remaining cells, we put the value of the actual pixel xy plus the cell from the top, table of y-1x, plus the cell from the left, table of yx-1, and we subtract the cell from the top left, table of y-1x-1. The nested expressions are just arithmetic operations between tuples. After the loop, we just return the table. Now in our boxplore function, after calling the function we made now to build the summed area table, for each pixel xy, we want the sum of pixels of the subimage from x-r, y-r to x+r, y+r. Here j start and I start are x minus r and y minus r respectively, and j end and I end are x plus r and y plus r respectively. Therefore, the sum is table of y plus r x plus r minus table of y plus r x minus r minus 1 minus table of y minus r minus 1 x plus r plus table of y minus r minus 1 x minus r minus 1. Once again, the nested expressions are just arithmetic operations between tuples. Note that we skipped two more rows and columns to avoid going out of bounds in the summed area table. X now goes from r plus 1 to width minus r minus 1, and y from r plus 1 to height minus r minus 1. We divide it by area, and we assign it to the pixel in the new image. After the loop, we return our blurred image. Now for the time complexity, building the summed area table costs O of h times w because we traverse all the pixels, but now an iteration costs O of 1 only because we're able to get the sum for the new pixel in O of 1 by using the table we made. This is why we got an O of h times w time complexity. And for the space complexity, we got O of h times w because of the table and the new image. We finished learning about box blur, but know that we have other types of blur, for example Gaussian blur. Also, if you really need to box blur an image in Python, just use the PIL function, which is faster than the code we've seen. The code we've seen is just to understand how does it work. We reached the end of this video. I hope that now you know how boxplore and filters in general work. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and see you in the next one.